Hate Me started, the chorus, don't hate me more than I hate myself, like that felt right. Right, like that was the only thing that existed, was that melody and that chorus. And knowing us, it couldn't ever just be like simple. We couldn't just be like, oh, this is just a song about not wanting somebody to hate you. We started jamming it together. The bridge section happened and we all started doing this. And we're like kind of laughing while we're doing it because we're a rock band. And I guess if somebody from another genre of music's like, isn't that all the same? But no, like our version of rock, we just don't do that stuff. Like that's a very specific subset of music. But we were doing it and like loving it. We were just having a blast. It sounded good. We were having fun doing it. And we're like, should we do that? Like, can we do that? Is this okay for us to do this? And there still weren't lyrics written yet. We recorded it, we did it. And then when it came time for the lyrics, I got super excited. And I was like, guys, I have an idea. I wanna do this rant part where I sort of validate us changing the style and the sound of our band, because that's what the character who is singing the song would do. And it became this whole meta narrative that is so much more fun to talk about than just, yeah, it's about heartbreak. You know, like I'm so sick of saying that. Although this album, I haven't had to say that once. Like it's about being really, really heartbroken. But it was just a way to make a more interesting narrative that felt more appropriate to what our band does without sounding like our band. And crushed it, by the way, good drums. Especially. That was another thing too, though, musically, where you didn't plan any of that stuff. You just went in, we pressed record, it was sick. Now that we recorded the take to test it out, should we like get into it? And all of us were like, no, you're done. I think you were the one who was like, can we just keep that? I like that.
Yeah.
That's something that only happens when you self-produce. I don't know, I mean, maybe there is, but I think a producer typically would be like, no, you gotta get all your kick drum patterns perfect and everything has to sync up to the grid and then it's gonna be edited to shit. When we're all, it's just the four of us in the room and there's nobody else telling us what we can and can't do. Moments like that are just on the fly. The take was perfect. It sounds really cool. If you had done that live, we would have been like, sick. So why not just leave that in the recording and not tamper with it? And no timing editing either. So for any music nerds, nowadays you're cutting up tracks like crazy, and when the drum track especially is played, you're sliding all the timing of every hit to the grid, so everything is like robotic and perfect. And we did that with our last album because I pushed it, I think, more, and I don't regret it, but I pushed it more then. And just for some reason on this round, there was a level of confidence in everything that we had learned from the first album and touring it, where we just felt like we could pull this off without having to do all the things that you're told you're supposed to in the morning. Okay. So that was cool. Don't Hate Me is just a great example of that, because everything that was done was one out of character for us and out of character for how you would normally make a song like that. Don't